What do you do to get through the winter when you're the best GT team in the world? You race in the Andros Trophy, a unique championship run on ice circuits in France. In 2016, WRT ran two Audi A1s. These cars were four-wheel drive, four-wheel steering and developed in-house. The drivers, Olivier Panis, Adrien Tambay, Lionel Daziano and Bérénice Demoustier. In ice racing, the track changes every lap. The ice changes every minute and in some corners even disappears. The engineers work overtime to find the best setup to keep the damage to the limited number of studded tires under control. Add to that a qualifying session in which the drivers fight against the clock to determine their starting position in the finals. Finals in which it is very difficult to overtake. Experience is important in the Andros Trophy, both in finding the right setup and in the driving itself. Having done only one season in the past, WRT started the 2015-16 season against much more experienced teams, but they were ready for the task. René Verbist and his men managed to get their Audi A1 to the front and got the respect from all. From the start of the competition in Val Thorens, Daziano managed to take the win in the Elite category, while Panis finishes on the podium in Elite Pro. Not only is the WRT Audi the most beautiful car of the field, it proves to be one of the most efficient as well. During the rest of the winter season, WRT conquered one podium finish after another. In Lanson-Varcor, the gorgeous circuit in between the pine trees, Adrien Tambay shines. And he takes us for a little slippery ride. The consistency and professionalism of WRT let them fight for the championship up until the last round. They came very close to grabbing the driver's title, but the Belgian Audi Club was crowned best team of the Andros Trophy. A first title for the team in 2016, and it's not even spring yet. ...2016 will be an important year for WRT. Ever since Vincent Vos, René Verbist and Yves Weerts created the team in 2009, it has grown every year. At the beginning of 2016, the team even moves up a gear and undergoes a thorough reorganization. The official team presentation for the press takes place at the workshop, with the attendance of plenty of journalists and important guests. The American Star presentation shows the ambition of the team, which consists of 21 full-time employees and dozens of drivers, mechanics, engineers and other technicians that join the team during the race weekends. Come spring, the war machine is ready. You might have forgotten how lousy the 2016 spring was. Winter took a long time to leave Europe, and the best example, the Nürburgring 24 hours. WRT returned to the Eiffel as the defending champions with the ambition to win again. But the Nürburgring 24 is arguably the most difficult race in the world. The Nürburgring 24 Hours is the most important race in Germany, and by conquering it in 2015, WRT earned the infinite respect of Audi Sport. This year the R8 was at a disadvantage, with the balance of performance being in favour of the new Mercedes. But the two WRT cars, driven by Vantor, Müller, Mies and Kaffer on one car, and Sandström, Verwisch, Frenz and Leonard on the other, fought like lions. Vincent Voss's man qualified in 10th and 22nd, and would try to get the best strategy. The beginning of the race was simply chaos. Shortly after the start, a massive hailstorm hit the circuit. Edward Sandström nearly flew off. But after a magical save, he got his R8 LMS back to pit lane for a sheer endless race interruption. Once the cars got going again, the WRT Audis had everything under control. The one car of Vantor, Müller, Mies and Kaffer was right behind the leading Mercedes. The other Audi WRT was a bit further behind, but still in contention. Not bad, with two of the four drivers being a Nürburgring 24 rookie. There's always magic in the air when it gets dark in the Eiffel. The atmosphere is quite unique, and the R8s of the Belgian Audi Club move up the rankings. Early hours, everything changes. Nico Müller cannot avoid contact with a spinning car and has to spend 3 hours in the garage to repair a broken suspension. Other Audis are hit as well. The green hell takes its toll on the R8s, and only one survives: the WRT car of Sandström, Verwisch, Frenz and Leonard. But it was an unequal fight all through the race. The Audis never stood a chance, and the WRT car finished in 8th, as first of the Audis, in front of much more experienced teams.
goal is to give Audi the best position as possible. We are not having a war between the teams. We are just hoping to have the best result as possible, whoever is in front. We finished with both cars. We had a lot of work to do on those cars, and the guys did a great job again, as usual. And yeah, now let's go to Spa and let's see if we can do better.
In 2016, the team makes its debut in the TCR International Championship. WRT enters two Vivi Golfs in the colors of Team Leopard for Jean-Carl Vernet and reigning champion, the temperamental Stefano Cummini. The team quickly shows it's up to the challenge, and in the third round in Spa, the Leopard boys crush the competition after one of the most hectic races of the year.
The lights go on. Oh, a long time this one. The lights go off. And it would seem that the front row made a good start. But there comes Cummini. Contact between the two Volkswagens. It's Vernet who's marginally ahead. Cummini also goes around the outside of La Source. Everybody cleanly through, it appears, apart from one of the Liqui Moly Engstler cars running wide. But it's Vernet who leads from Antiburi. Then it's Cummini third. Trying to count the cars through, and it would appear as Cummini moves to block Matohomola and goes through the inside to take second place. So it's 1-2 for the turquoise Leopard Racing team. Jean-Carl Vernet leads from Stefano Cummini. Antiburi now slips to third. Jean-Carl Vernet in the number two Volkswagen Golf of Leopard Racing takes the checkered flag. The headlights flash on Stefano Cummini's car, second for him, third for our pole sitter Antiburi. A 1-2-3 for the team, a 1-2-3 for Volkswagen.
The team is used to working with the R8 V10 LMS, and the TCR with its front-wheel drive cars with four-cylinder engines is quite different. A new work mode has to be found. The format of the races is new as well, with two 30-minute races that follow each other closely. So the team almost has to start from zero, but they are quick learners. After the 1-2-3 in Spa, the Golfs are not the best suited car on the ultra-quick Imola track, but Stefano Cummini still manages to win the qualifying race. Has a tougher weekend with his hard contact with Serbian giant Borkovic. TCR is all about door-to-door racing, and these things can happen sometimes. The European TCR campaign of Team Leopard also saw a splendid race of Cummini and Vernet on the Austrian Salzburg Ring, when the duo finished first and third on a very wet track. The rest of the season takes place during the summer months, and it will end in autumn with some exotic races in Asia. Spring also sees some long travels for the team. With the Blancpain GT Sprint and Endurance Series, the truckies have to move tons and tons of gear to no fewer than 10 races. They have to drive thousands of kilometers from Belgium to Great Britain to Hungary, Germany, Italy, Spain and France. This season, WRT enters 6 cars in the sprint races and 5 in the endurance events. That requires huge efforts from the logistics department, and it's not easy to keep track of everything.
And the first main race of the season is go! Down towards the first corner, it's not the best start from the Bentley. A look up the inside, around the outside goes Philippe!
But from the start of the championship, all worries are forgotten when the new pairing of Fred Vervisch and Laurens Vanthoor take a first win in the sprint race in Misano.
Door handles as they come all the way around turn 4, turn 5, and look at that, the BMW is still in there. Vervisch goes around the outside of 6, lays to rest the demons of Misano 2015 with victory in the opening race of the 2016 Blancpain GT Series. Move to the top of the championship after the first round. Great drive from the WRT guys.
A couple of weeks later, at the other end of Europe, Chris Mies and Enzo Ide take the win in Brands Hatch. The German-Belgian duo lays down the marker.
Right up behind Enzo Ide, he's right in the wheel tracks of that WRT Audi. Pulls to the outside on the run down towards Paddock Hill Bend. He'll then hold back, brake early, get on the power and see if he can get the cut back.
The very quick amateur driver Enzo Ide and Audi Sport factory driver Christopher Mies do not know it yet. This race will be the foundation on which Enzo will build his season and will conquer the driver's title in the sprint championship. All smiles in sprint for WRT, but the endurance races prove to be a harder nut to crack. It takes all the knowledge and strategic experience of the team to pull a stunt like the one from Silverstone, when Fred Vervisch and the Vanthoor brothers, Laurens and Dries, managed to finish in second after a thriller of a race. A faultless strategy established by the engineers and team managers, and perfectly executed pit stops by the mechanics were required. Those pit stops are crucial in the Blancpain races. In the sprint championship, the best pit stop crew gets rewarded every weekend and at the end of the season. It's no coincidence that the WRT mechanics occupy all 3 podium steps at the end of the season, beating the mechanics of the other teams. When summer comes around, it's time for the most important race of the year for the WRT team, the total 24 hours of Spa. In Vincent Voss's backyard, WRT has always been at its best, with 2 wins in 6 participations and always at least 1 car on the podium. In the Belgian Ardennes, WRT is not only the team to beat, but also an example of how it should be done.
It has been, from the start, the best presented team. I mean, now the competition is catching up, you know. I mean, they were the, you know, from a presentation standpoint, they were always number one. Now some teams are coming at the same level, and some other manufacturers are also challenging Audi, which has been one of the most supportive manufacturers in the world of GT3 for years now. But I think Vincent and his team are not afraid of competition, and it will make their performance even more valuable.
A major upset after qualifying in Spa, when the dominating Mercedes cars are all penalised, and it's the Audi of René Rast on pole position. The R8 of Frains is 5th on the grid, with the 3 other WRT cars a bit further behind. The opening hours of the Spa 24 hours are always very eventful. Avoiding contacts and technical issues are key during this phase of the race, and the 15 WRT drivers complete their tasks perfectly. But some hours later, there's trouble afoot. At the beginning of the night, René Rast is driving the 28 car when he is hit by a Jaguar. He has to come back to pit lane for lengthy repairs. When the car gets back on track, it's 4 laps down in 42nd position. A victory is out of the question.
Don't box applause, don't box applause.
Dries Van Toor, Fred Vervish and Will Stevens also lose any chance of a good result with a broken splitter and a malfunctioning fuel pump. The hardest hit comes on Sunday morning when Robin Frain sparks the two car. A blown engine is the verdict. A tough blow, for together with teammates Leonard and Meadows, the Dutchman was aiming for a podium finish. It's the only car of five that has to retire. Vervish, Van Toor and Stevens eventually finish in 29th, Albuquerque, Baptista and Jimenez in 12th, and Kaffer, Delaner and Baguette claim 8th position after 24 hours. But during the final hours of the race, everybody in the WRT box holds their breaths to witness the majestic comeback of the 28 car. Mura, Van Toor and Rast pull all the stops, and with less than an hour to go, they even reclaim a chance of winning the race. But then, the infamous spar weather strikes again. A violent thunderstorm wreaks havoc on the track, pit stops are completed in total chaos, and with a fantastic final rush of Laurens Van Toor, lapping some 10 seconds quicker than all the other drivers, the WRT team eventually claims the third step on the rostrum. It's the sixth time in succession that WRT gets at least one of its cars on the podium in the Spa 24 hours. The comeback of Van Toor, Rast and Müller will always be one of the highlights in the history of the team. The podium in Spa was not enough to fight for the Blancpain GT Endurance title though, but there is more success to come in the form of another sprint win for the Belgian Audi Club in Budapest. When he was a driver, team boss Vincent Vos always loved to race here, and now it's WRT's turn to shine. In the qualifying race, the Audis of Vervish, Van Toor and Ede Mies are already at the front. Chris Mies puts the 33 car in the best position possible, and as always, the WRT mechanics do a perfect job at the pit stop. Enzo Ede takes the lead.
He's taking over, and with respect, Enzo Ede, a fine amateur driver, but what Christopher Mies...
And after an exceptional second half of the race, Enzo Ede wins it.
Round the final corner, and heading towards a famous victory, and a chequered flag is in waiting there. And yes, it falls, and Enzo Ede. But here they are, the winners, on the top of the podium. And Enzo Ede deserves to smile.
With Van Toor and Vervish third on the grid, and the Mercedes in second, the Budapest main race will be a tense affair. During the briefing, Thierry Tassin repeats what is at stake.
We give advantage to the leading WRT driver, so don't attack him into turn one, and try to run away together.
Enzo Ede takes the start, and there is obviously a bit of tension. And the start shows why.
Side by side, and no, indeed, it's the Audi. And look at that other Audi coming through on the inside, and they're almost rubbing each other.
Ede drives a perfect first stint and gives the car to Mies. He has to finish the job. Thanks to this runner-up spot, Chris Mies and Enzo Ede are now in an ideal position for the final round of the season in Barcelona. The GT program may be the best known of WRT's activities, but the team also plays a major role in a championship that is immensely popular in Belgium, France, England, and since recently, even in Dubai and the United States. The Fun Cup. The highlight of the Fun Cup is the Spa 25 hours in the midst of summer. There are some 120 cars at the start, and there is a unique atmosphere. 2012, WRT is responsible for the manufacturing and maintenance of the front cups. During the 25 hours, an important team of mechanics is at the track to give all the teams a hand during the weekend. In 2015, WRT set another step forward by acquiring AMP, the welding specialists, to improve and optimize the production of the front cup chassis. There's no denying the success of the Fun Cup. The third generation of cars, with their 2-litre engine and a sequential gearbox developed by VW Motorsport and WRT under the masterful eye of technical director René Verbiest, is a true racing car. A tubular frame with a glass fiber bodywork, a 2-litre engine that produces just under 180 bhp, and a car weighs less than 800 kilograms. That makes the car very pleasant to drive, and it allows both experienced racers and pure rookies to participate. And success keeps on growing, and that makes us very happy. With 400 cars built, one could even say that WRT is the most important Belgian car manufacturer. The Fun Cup is very popular. Professional drivers are drawn to it to race with a majority of amateur drivers. What is interesting is that we learn how to drive in a pack and we learn how to defend. So I think it's a very good learning formula that could set talented youngsters on their way. It's a good follow-up to karting indeed. But it also launches the not-so-young, the 40-year-olds or the 50-year-olds who would like to participate in a day of racing. And the Fun Cup is a real racing car. Jean-Michel is probably the best example. He started off in the Fun Cup and now races in the Blancpain GT Sports Club at the wheel of an Audi R8. At the start of autumn, there's a big surprise. WRT enters a Ligier in the ELMS Championship race in Spa. It makes sense to put Laurence Vanthoor and Will Stevens at the wheel. A couple of months earlier, they participated in the Le Mans 24 hours. For Dries Vanthoor, however, it's the first time at the wheel of a prototype. A big first for Dries then, and also for the team. But once more, WRT will show its skills, even though the weekend starts very badly.
On my second lap, I had the throttle which jammed, so it stayed stuck on the entry of a pretty quick corner. We have a lot of question marks. I think we still have a strong package, but a lot of question marks, and very difficult to give a prediction for tomorrow.
At first glance, the car is hardly damaged, but that's just at first glance.
We did not see it that the monocoque was damaged, but after qualifying, we saw and we had to take the decision to change the monocoque. So that's what we are doing now. You see the guy behind stripping the car down, and there is a monocoque coming from Le Mans, will arrive around 3 a.m, and then the rebuild will start, and it will go.
The team will spend the night fixing the car, and the rebuild is only finished on the starting grid. The car is barely ready to race. In these circumstances, the WRT guys do not even expect to finish the first stint. Will Stevens, a year before at the wheel of an F1 in Spa, will take the start. And we're off for 4 hours. Stevens gets to the front quickly. The Ligier is working perfectly and the drivers get their confidence back. When Stevens gets back to pit lane, Dries Vanthoor is in an ideal position to fight for a good result.
Let's
team did a fantastic job to get the car ready, and the car felt good. So the first few laps were a bit unknown, but after that I managed to get my head down and could do some good laps.
He's barely 18, but Dries Van Toor drives a fantastic stint, very consistent, without making any mistakes. He even takes the lead. In the WRT box, they can hardly believe their eyes. In the end, De Ligier has to concede the win to Nicolas Lapierre, the future ELMS champion. Lorenz Van Toor completes the 4 hours of Spa in second, a result that a couple of hours earlier, nobody had expected. Jacques Nicollet, De Ligier boss, cannot believe what just happened. This is the best result of the year for Ligier.
I'm
extremely happy for our first experience of a team that is one of the best in GT racing. This is wonderful. I am very proud of this result, and especially because we conquered it together with Vincent Voss. I met Vincent a couple of years ago, and our history has almost come full circle now. I'm really happy with this. They're a great team.
Ça me fait vraiment très très plaisir. C'est une très très belle équipe.
We finished the weekend in a very nice way. We finished second on the podium. After all what happened, it was an incredible reward to all the guys. It's a great achievement. A lot of people are asking me if this will have a future. I do not know, but I hope so.
Santé! Santé, les gars!
Allez,
à WRT, hein!
Merci à vous!
The last Blancpain sprint race takes place in Barcelona. Chris Mies, Enzo Ida's teammate, is driving in the GT Masters in Germany, and it's Robin Frains who will assist Enzo Ida in his title quest. After the Jungharo ring, Enzo Ida took the lead of the championship. Now he can adapt his race tactics to the chasing Mercedes drivers. And that is exactly what he does, and then some.
We are under half a minute on the clock. This is the final lap of the race. And in terms of the Sprint Cup, that's what Enzo Ida is focusing on. There is his mother. She's starting to believe. Down the inside, but through the final corner to take the checkered flag comes Enzo Ida.
The two comrades get the perfect result in the qualifying race. After yet another faultless pit stop by the WRT mechanics, Ida and Frains take the win.
One more point to win the championship, and with the main race coming in 1 hour or so, it looks good, but everything can still happen.
And so Enzo is on pole position of the season finale of the Blancpain GT Sprint Series. Right behind him, his fierce competitors.
Will there be a dive up the inside from number 33? Of course there will, because Robin Freins is at the wheel. He fancies it. They love it. Just get back on the circuit. But there's a clump. The Bentley comes across, gives it a cloud. It was worth a go. The fact is the 33 is still going. Has he got a puncture? The tail was swinging round there. Oh, drama right to the finish. He just has to trickle down through the final sequence of corners. There's turn 13, down to 14 and 15. He had a go. He couldn't help himself. Victory in the final race of the year, going to the number 88 crew. Clear win, 6 and a bit seconds for the Acca ASP Mercedes team. This is the battle for second, third, fourth and fifth. It's the Bentley, then the two Audis, and so the Sprint Cup goes to Enzo Eder.
Eder and Freins do what they have to do and finish on the third step of the podium. Enzo Eder, a talented amateur driver, takes the Blancpain Sprint title against pro drivers such as Buco Baumann, a childhood dream come true.
For sure, when I was 10 years, I was go-karting in Spa on the go-kart circuit, and then I saw the cars passing on the big circuit, and I said to my uncle at that time, when I'm 18, I will drive on the big track and not anymore on the small track. So it was really a dream for me to be on this level, to race real race cars on the high level. So now I achieved to, together with Christopher and with Robin, to win this championship. So for me, it's really great.
WRT also takes the team's title in the sprint competition and finishes in second in the Blancpain Endurance and overall rankings.
Let's show. Hip, hip, hip!
During the autumn, WRT continues its harvest of titles and cups. In TCR Benelux, where it enters a Seat and a Golf, the team will conquer the title crown. But more importantly, it also discovers some promising young talents. The duo Sam de Jonge and Denis Dupont, for instance. At the wheel of the Seat in RACV colors, they win two races, one in Assen and one in Zandvoort, finishing third in the championship. Then there is Max Potti. The youngster competed in the WRT Karting Academy in 2015 and is the revelation of the championship, even though it's only his first season in car racing. His performances became stronger at every race, and at the Comarbac track he even won a race, sharing a car with Stefano Comini himself. Not bad for a first season in the TCR Benelux. You can bet that the youngsters that went through the hands of the WRT team will soon make the step to a higher level. In the TCR Championship, the autumn races turn out to be a ferocious battle between the Seat and the Team Leopard drivers. Stefano Comini wins the first race in Russia, Jean-Carl Vernet does the same in Singapore, and he's back in the title race. The season finale is held in the streets of Macau. An enormous WRT delegation travels to the gambling capital for the final fireworks of 2016. The GT team participates in the GT World Cup with two Audi R8s for Mortara and Vantor, and the TCR team is there with the Golfs. The pressure's on for Comini and Vernet, since both can still win the world title. Stefano has the best position, for he is second in the standings, behind Seat driver James Nash. JK Vernet needs the perfect weekend to claim the world crown. Pressure or not, Stefano Comini is as spectacular as ever. He's without a doubt the first driver in the history of the Macau Grand Prix to take the hairpin using the handbrake. In the rain, the two Leopard cars qualify on the front row. The pressure is clearly visible on Comini's face. He knows it can go wrong quickly on the streets of Macau. At the green light, Vernet and Comini get the perfect start and leads the Macau Grand Prix.
Out they go, away we go. Not a great start from Vernet at all. Good start from the third place man. Great reaction by Vernet as he goes round the outside to grab second for a moment anyway. Has he made it? Yes, and in fact, look at that. That's exactly the tactics. And he could get penalised for that.
But as always on these twisty and narrow streets, there's plenty of crashes left and right. James Nash is involved in one of them.
Drama has come at Macau because the championship leader is out of the Macau Grand Prix.
The Seat does not score a single point in the first race. Worse, the car is severely damaged and it's far from certain the mechanics will be able to repair the car. Meanwhile, Comini wins the qualifying race from Vernet. Confidence reigns in the Leopard team. The Volkswagen drivers now have their fate in their own hands.
Lights come on! Out they go!
The goals have a good start, but quickly Thiago Montero takes the lead.
He's already up to second place and already vying for the lead. Brilliant start by the Portuguese. He comes alongside Comini. He's got this, you know. And Comini will try to stop him at Mandarin. But I think Thiago Montero has got the lead here at Macau.
Vernet protects his teammate against the attacks of the other Seat drivers. There's a fierce battle for the podium positions, and when the Frenchman passes his Swiss teammate, the Leopard clan holds his breath. The end of the race is even more stressful because Oriola is gaining ground on Comini. Wisely, Stefano lets the Spanish driver past. Vernet ends the race in second, with Comini in fourth. Enough to retain the driver's title in TCR International. In its first season, the Leopard team sets an exceptional performance.
This is my second win in TCR. But this time is really different, because this time is not my win, is the win of Leopard Racing and WRT. This is a win that we all together work to be here.
And the great atmosphere in the team created some promises that some should never have made. Of course, Macau is also the famous Formula 3 Grand Prix. No wonder this one's called the Asian Monaco Grand Prix. Since 2015, there's also the GT World Cup, and WRT participates for the second time, aiming for one of the rare wins that has eluded them thus far. To optimize their chances, the Audi strategists have chosen Eduardo Mortara, multiple Formula 3 winner on the streets of Macau, and the best GT3 driver of the moment, Laurens Vanthoor.
So,
two fiery characters that Vincent Vos will have to keep under control all during the weekend. Qualifying goes well, with Mortara taking pole position from Vanthoor. In the qualifying race, one of the major points is to avoid the traditional first corner crash.
Out go the lights, away we go, and a great start from both the Porsches and the Mercedes. One of the Audis is out, spun right round at the first corner. And it's, would you believe it, Mr. Macau is out! And another one!
That's Müller again. That's a second smash for Nico Müller, who spun round at, he's in all sorts of trouble there.
After the severe crash of Nico Müller, the race is red flagged. The WRT mechanics manage to get Mr. Macau's car rolling again. Once the race gets underway, Laurens Vanthoor can cruise to the finish of the qualifying race to claim pole position for the main race. Everybody within the team wants this win, especially since it's Laurens' very last race for WRT. So all is put in order to give the 8 car the best chances possible. Sunday is race day. Eduardo Mortara will start from the back with Laurens Vanthoor on pole position for his last race with WRT. A very emotional moment.
It's the GT World Cup from Macau. Laurens Vanthoor with two Porsches in close pursuit. Good start from Mercedes. Oh, the bolt! Touched the barrier for a moment. But down towards the run towards Mandarin. It is Laurens Vanthoor of Audi who leads the way.
And another race interruption. It will take ages, and everybody is on edge when the GT World Cup finally restarts.
Laurens Vanthoor leads them away, but Bamba got away well. But he needs to. He's got a 5-second penalty. He's right behind Laurens Vanthoor, and this is a good position now to overtake. Wow, we're on board with Bamba. He comes side by side with Laurens Vanthoor as they head towards Mandarin. This is going to be dicey. Brilliant overtake by Bamba. How do you do? Oh, no! No, 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 no! Macau strikes again! And the horrible, horrible sight of Laurens Vanthoor upside down and in flames almost, it looks. As Macau ends for him in a dramatic way. Laurens Vanthoor, let's hold our breath, folks, that he's okay. Red flag.
The race is red flagged again and will not restart. Because Laurens was leading the last time the cars crossed the line, he wins the GT World Cup in a unique fashion.
Yes, it is our first World Championship or World Cup. We're quite proud of the achievement, even if obviously, as you could see in the race, it is not exactly the way we like to do it, but yeah, we have led most of the lap, and as I said, it's a World Cup. The results shows that we won this World Cup, and we are, as a team, we did everything that needs to be done, and we are quite proud of it.
And this is the end of WRT's four seasons of 2016. 2017 is already around the corner, for WRT never stops racing.